So, a very good afternoon to all my beloved 6th semester students of BBA department. Today, I have uploaded this video in YouTube where I'll discuss a part of your syllabus which is related to your 5th unit of Strategic Human Resource Management. I have also circulated the notes in your WhatsApp group. Please go through it. Although the part which I was supposed to take up and the portion which was allotted to me, we have already had the discussion in the college, that is the 1st and the 2nd unit of International Trade and Business. But since it has been a long time that I have not been able to come in touch with you, or you have not been able to come in touch with me, so I have decided that I will upload this video. It is not possible to simulate the ambience of a class totally, but I will try to do it as much as possible. This subject, Strategic Human Resource Management, will be discussed thoroughly and elaborately by your Jayajit Majumdar sir. A part of it is also being discussed by your Jaydeep Bhattacharjee sir, our coordinator sir, and we are very grateful to him. Amra onar proti khubi kritoggo je uni onar shastho ta bhalo na thaka sotteo uni je bhabe amaderke support kore gechen. And we are also grateful to the other teachers of BBA department. As per their convenience, they have extended support to the students. Anyways, if you look at the notes, you will see that in the first page there is a discussion on the concept of human resource management. So the concept of international human resource management is quite similar to the context of international marketing which you have studied in your marketing strategy. So whenever an organization decides to go international, what basic difference in the operations an organization has to undergo? Basically, when an organization decides to go international, the landscape or the context in which the functions are being performed, it will change. The context will change, the landscape will become broader, but functionally the particular department performs the same functions. As it is mentioned that international human resource management deals with procurement, allocation and utilizing of human resource in a global context so that the objectives of the organizations are fulfilled. Now, this is same in case of domestic human resource management also, but in case of domestic human resource management, the area of operation is quite confined. It is confined to a particular country, but in case of international human resource management, the area expands. It pervades more than one country. It encompasses more than one country. So this is the basic difference. But when we look at the feature, the first feature basically tells that functionally international and domestic human resource management will execute the same functions, only the context will differ. The second feature, if you look at it, you will see that in case of international human resource management, an organization needs to deal with three kinds of employees. One is referred to as the parent country national, the other is referred to as the host country national, and the third is referred to as the third country national. Now, what is parent country national? Parent country national refers to those employees who belong to a country where the headquarters of the organization is located. And host country national would refer to employees of those countries where the firm is executing its operations. And the third country nationals refer to the employees of those countries who belong neither from parent nor from host. So why third country national is also important? Because the source of human resource, the source of supply of human resource for an organization can be, can be the whole globe, you can say, or the source of supply of human resource can come from different countries. It is not only the parent and the host country which will supply the human resource. So that is why we need to take into consideration the third, country nationals also. So, and organizations will, contain third country nationals also. The third point, it is basically an extension of the second point where it refers that in international human resource management, we need to deal with three countries. One is referred to as the parent country. Parent country is the country where the firm's headquarters is located, or you can say the origin of the organization is the parent country. Host country is the country where the firm will carry out its operation, and the third country is the country which is neither the parent nor the host country. So you can obviously understand that the third country is the country which will be a source of supply of resources. The source of supply of resources can also be the parent and the host country. In fact, primarily the resources are supplied from the parent and the host country, but we cannot totally nullify the possibility of the supply of resources from the other countries, from the third countries. since the organization has expanded its operations and become multinational, so we have to take into consideration the third country also, you can understand that there can be more than one third country and there can be more than one host country. When an organization decides to open up its branches in more than one country, then of course there are more than one host countries. When the organization decides to collect or acquire the resource, raw materials or the human resource from more than one country, then there are more than one third countries. So this is basically the concept of international human resource management. But apart from the concept, what is more pertinent is, and what more we need to understand elaborately is the difference between the international and the domestic human resource management. So this is, there is a table, if you look at the second page of your notes that I have circulated in the WhatsApp, where in the table there are 6 points of distinction between the international and the domestic human resource management. The first point says that in case of international human resource management, the activities are more and the activities are varied. Or you can say that the volume of activity within a particular sub-function for the department will also be more. A very good example is being mentioned in the first point, where it is where the example goes like this, that if an employee is being given an international assignment, then the training would be additional, because the training would just not include imparting of skills, just not would include nurture a purpose of skill development for the employees, but it would also include a purpose of enabling the employees to adjust in a nation which is unfamiliar. Because when an employee has to perform the function in a unfamiliar landscape, in an unfamiliar terrain, then adjustment he needs to make in that particular location, in that particular nation, will also need to be trained. So this is another aspect that is included in the training of employees who are given an international assignment. So this is about the first point of distinction between international and domestic human resource management. So read till this point and see whether there is any confusion.